Guesting with Frank Skinner, Jerry Halliwell and the Crankies tonight after the soccer.
Great dilemmas is, can you be buddies with someone who doesn't like sport? Well, this week we're going to put that to the test by meeting, hooking up with and trying to convert two people who are the embodiment of indoor culture. In short, two of Britain's foremost couch potatoes.
Hello, we're Adam and Joe, and this week we're Dermot's sporting buddies.
So let's take a closer look at my two new buddies, Adam Buxton and Joe Cornish.
Hello.
The talent for student union was honed while studying at London's posh Westminster College. They first met age 13, along with fellow school buddy Louis Theroux. Since their big break on late night access show Takeover TV, these two have proven the old adage that two brains are better than one. Bringing us vinyl justice, Adam's bad dad.
I've had a sort of vision of hell.
And lots of toys. In their own homemade way, Adam and Joe are reminiscent of the old masters at their very best. Sort of a Chuckle Brothers for the 21st century.
It's Ben Shepherd.
It's Vernon Kay. Excuse me, you've Vernon Kay off of T4.
It's neither of the above.
Are you June Sarpong from television?
That is right.
Are you Hufty from The Word?
Am I Hufty from The Word? Yeah, it's not going too well lately. Hello, guys.
Hello. Dermot.
Welcome to Dermot Sporting Buddies. I hope you're very well. Now, you are the two most incongruous people we could have on the show because you hate sport, right?
Don't hate sport, just don't actually have any active interest in it.
I hate sport.
Mm-hmm. But you're willing to give it a go.
What's more, I hate everybody who likes it.
That's interesting.
That's fighting talk.
Today, we've picked a sport that essentially encapsulates you two. It's raw, it's edgy, it's DIY, it's interactive.
Is it gay?
It is, in short. I wouldn't be saying that too much where we're going. It is, in short, stock car racing.
Gay stock car racing. Excellent.
What do you think?
That sounds great.
You serious?
No.
I like the idea of stock car racing. What don't you like about it?
The physical danger. I hate any sort of physical danger.
Well, that's going to be kind of 95% of it, I think. We're essentially going to the Monaco of stock car racing, which is Skegness. I've hired Old Red to get us there, and we're going to have an outdoor evening.
Give it a go anyway.
You got free weekend. Off to Skeggy then, guys. How are you feeling so far? No one's travel sick, are they?
Slightly frightened by your driving, Dermot.
Are you?
When you take both hands off the wheel, it's a bit alarming.
I'll make sure they're stapled.
We veer close to the edge.
Look at the road.
Okay. So let's get this straight. You guys have never been into sport, even when you were little. Did you not support a team in London or anything?
No. Never. I never have an answer to the question, what team do you support?
Well, there was a team called Buxton that was invariably bottom of some bottom division.
Yeah.
So I support Buxton.
How long did that last for? Do you still do that now?
No, I thought about doing it yesterday when I was in the taxi and the taxi driver said, so, what team are you supporting? And I was like, I always feel bad. I feel like they're going to beat me up or think less of me if I go, well, to be honest with you, I don't care about sport, and especially football. I find it very boring. And by extension, you, quite boring.
When you were at school, you just had a choice of what sports you wanted to do.
Yeah, in the end, we just did art.
Yeah.
That was considered a sport.
Yeah,
exactly.
Okay.
But when we were young, you had to do hardcore sports, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I quite like rugby, but I wasn't very good at it and always invariably got picked last for any team.
So is
and
that
that's,
why...
that's where the humiliation element comes. So sport for me equals humiliation and bullying.
But Dermot, would you say you were a bit thick?
I wasn't the sharpest. I left school with two GCSEs. My dad said, well, I'll give you another chance. And then after that, you've kind of...
Because I equate sport with people who, you know, the brain's not so good, so they develop the body.
That's out of order.
You know, you're blind, so your hearing improves.
It's a terrible prejudice to have.
You're stupid, so your body improves.
Were you guys...
But that is basically what my prejudice is. And I'm sure it's wrong and horrible.
Well, I can't...
That's the kind of talk that... used to get you kicked in.
Well, exactly.
It's the kind of talk I'm going to get kicked in this weekend.
I may well be kicked in this weekend.
Well, just to clear up, we're going to Skegness.
Yeah.
Stock car racing.
Yeah.
That kind of softy southerner talk ain't going to go down that well.
Oh, stock car racing is a brain sport. I guess another reason why I maybe don't like sport is that I'm personally deeply competitive and I hate to lose. And I only really like to get into things which I know I'll win.
Like video games that you can play on your own.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think that is true. So I just don't really...
I was going to ask, what else can you do apart from sport that...
Is wanking a sport?
Everyone's
the way we do it.
Surely.
I'm very good at that. Can we stop at the services? Can we stop at the services?
Yes, we can.
Can we stop at the services?
This is us.
You're cringing.
I'm smiling, man.
Sing along, German. Pussy, pussy, pussy. Boom, boom, boom.
Football. Go.
Boom, boom, boom. Footy, footy, footy. Boom, boom, boom.
Okay, we need magazines.
Yep.
We need sweets.
Yep.
We need audiobooks for self-help and self-improvement.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go take a call on my
No.
Pop.
Can I get
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
Ask your mother.
Please.
Wine gum pastels.
No, because I need it. Because I need because it's a purse. Because I can use it at school for my money. For my money.
Dad,
please.
Can
please.
I have the money to charge
no.
up my pop mobile?
Please. Because I can use it at school. Because I can use it at school. Please. Dad, no, please, because you remember you said...
No.
No, please.
Hey, how to get your point across in 30 seconds or less, Dermot?
Oh, yeah, geez. Give me that.
Can we get this? It's got a free purse. In case that one runs out.
No, relax.
Please, please.
Dad, can I have this magazine about bananas?
Yes, you can.
Dad, look at these hair clips. Look at these hair clips. Please, can I please? Because you said I could get some hair clips. Please. Please, you say.
Horrible.
Please, you say.
Right. Dad, they've got Depravicus. I've been looking for Depravicus for ages by Ray Gordon.
I'm not paying for this.
The sequel to Oh Father.
Okay. Read out a quote and see if it.
Fucking hell.
It feels to me.
Sorry.
If that's that purse again.
Standing it's a makeup bag. It's not a purse, Dad. It's not a purse. It's not a purse. It's a makeup bag.
Standing or not, he was in for a morning of rampant sex. He knew as he led the girl down the embankment. He'd begin by licking the wet valley of her shape. Was he? He decided. Then lick and tongue her brown bottom hole.
No, we can't get that.
It doesn't say brown bottom hole.
It's Depravicus. It's a sequel to Oh Father.
Do you really want it?
Yes.
In my eyes.
Come on, that would be good to read out in the band.
Okay.
It's a long way to Skegness.
Come on. Late tonight.
Any book that you open, the first thing you read is Brown Bottom Hole.
What's this?
It's a demo track for an old synthesizer.
This is ridiculous.
It's excellent.
Who's going to have a go with this gobstopper?
Never trust the Rugrats.
What is it? Oh, you've got a lolly in there, like. Did you just put that in?
Shall we do the Eve magazine sex survey?
Yeah, let's.
Do you masturbate more or less now than you used to?
About the same?
Uh-huh.
About the same.
OK, I'm going to give you some personal questions, and you've got to see if you can figure out the answers. Question. Sometimes when my wife climaxes... She expels this gush of liquid. She says it's because I hit her G-spot, but it freaks me out. What is it?
Your wife is weeing on you. Ask your wife to go to the toilet before you start having sexual intercourse.
I get quite bad chafing on my nipples when I run. How can I avoid this? And why the hell do blokes have nipples anyway?
Blokes have nipples because originally women fed the children and the blokes fed the animals.
I'm going to run over some Caucasians today.
This is fun.
I'm so tired of being alive. Adam cannot drive. Soon we will be dead with metal in our heads. People say Adam's gay.
Oh dear.
How far now?
I reckon about 20 miles.
20 miles? You said that 20 miles ago.
Look, guys, I don't want to cause a ruckus, but we're only in Skegness.
Skegness! Coinsville?
Copperama?
Can we go arcade?
No.
Please, can we go arcade?
No.
Please,
no.
Can we
please,
go?
Please.
Tomorrow we go stock car racing. It's fine.
Yeah.
Before that,
yeah.
You show me your world of arcade.
Yes.
Get that one that's lying down, man. That'll be the one.
Which one?
The one lying down in the very middle. Get him in the middle of his chest. It's amazing. It's almost as if I'm in an arcade.
Hello. You've got rockets on your bike, Joe. Be careful. I just don't really agree with games that encourage shooting and violence. I just think it's irresponsible and depressing.
Come to Papa.
Never. It's never
going to happen. Come, little Zippy. Come, little Zippy. Come, little Zippy. Come, little Zippy.
Who makes these pigging machines?
One of them bit me.
Boys. Well, the Zippy front hasn't worked out. You spent approximately £128.
On trying to get that Zippy.
And we got that, which is...
fantastic.
Worth about that.
Some kind of dragon, no doubt. Should we go to the campsite?
Yes! Here's the campsite. So, wow, it really is just like a kind of field.
I bet you that this is the kind of place where Eminem grew up.
A trailer park?
Yes.
Well done, Adam.
And I bet you England's answer to Eminem is here tonight as we speak. If we go around and knock on a few doors, or rather, rap on a few doors, I bet you we'll find a very talented young man in there making up his own rhymes. He may be busy being beaten by his abusive mother or something like that, bless you.
So we've arrived at the campsite, and now presumably we're gonna go home. Or yeah. To a hotel.
Dermot's left, so it's a good time to say that if he seriously expects us to sleep in this shithole, he's got another thing coming.
Life was very boring, living in this town. Labor came into my world and turned it upside down. I'll play you the rest later.
Yeah.
Amazing. It's amazing.
Red wine and chips, it's a very something. So far so good, happy? Mm.
We're very happy. You're
feeling with buddies?
Yeah. We had a great day at the arcade, damn it.
Feeling like you're looking forward to a bit of like stock car racing tomorrow?
The only thing that slightly worries me
is the stock car racing.
It's the stock car racing. All right, then. Can I just say, he didn't say you can spit out
your... No, that wasn't...
That was an involuntary reaction.
When did you first pick up this?
Well, I started to learn this time last year, actually a bit earlier than that.
Really? God, you're really good.
Thank you for noticing. Don't laugh.
For this
like
time
that.
Last year. Who learnt first out of you two?
Well, Joe's always had some.
I started first. Skills. Adam copied me, and now he's better. Yeah. It's always the way.
Who copies who?
I tend to copy Joe, I think. Okay.
When you first met each other, what were your first impressions of the other one?
Well, we met at school in the playground, and we were both into 9 o'clock news, and we were doing that sketch where the two Russian agents meet each other in the park.
Or on your own, and the other one saw you from across the playground. Hey, he's doing the same sketch.
Almost.
I'm going to go and speak to you.
No, it was we were in the same English class, and the first time I went into this new English class, I saw Joe over by the window, bathed in golden light, and
golden rain.
bathed in my golden rain. And I went over and I'd sort of seen him around, you know.
Yeah, I'm hard to miss.
And because you know, I was too shy to say anything else serious, I just started riffing on this, not the 9 o'clock news sketch, like,
the winter is very cold, the geese will be needing thick coats, my friend. And then,
rather than walking away, as he should have done after that, Joe responded by saying something equally cryptic and Russian.
And what about Louis Theroux, because you're at college with him?
Oh, we don't want to talk about
Louis Theroux. We made it perfectly clear that we didn't want to talk about Louis Theroux. Stop. Fuck's sake.
And his bloody ratings and BAFTAs.
Did you hang out with him from the outset, or...? No, he hung out with us, he wanted to anyway. We didn't let him because he was too shit. And then he nicked all our stuff and then he went out and won a BAFTA.
I mean, weird weekends, my ass. We could tell you about some weird weekends. My stomach's making noises.
Is it?
You should have some more chips, man.
No,
what's the worst thing someone said to you about your stuff?
Oh, people, you know, some people just hate it, and that's fair enough. Some people just don't get it, just think it's rubbish. It's very lazy, yes, stupid and scatological.
And annoying, you know, student-y. People don't like it. Some people, like I met, what's her name? You know, Noel Gallagher's, the Queen. She's like the Queen. Noel Gallagher's girlfriend, Sarah. And she said,
Oh, we watched your show the other night, and I said, oh yeah, yeah. Well, you know, what do you think? Oh,
because you never think that someone's going to say that without it there being a compliment.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Well, why would they bring it up? He said, oh, it's quite cringy. I was like, oh right. How do you mean cringy? Like sort of edgy? And she said, no, just cringy. And I was like, right, what did Noel think of it then? She said, oh, Noel hates things like that. He just thinks it's student bollocks. I was like, right, anything good about it at all? I mean, I think Oasis is shit, if that's any consolation.
So I can reciprocate.
I actually do like Oasis, so I was a bit gutted by that.
Yeah. All right, guys, listen, early start tomorrow. You drunk far too much.
I've drunk nearly enough.
Well, right, with your one bottle of sporting wine.
Let's get an early night.
Okay, then.
Come on.
Let's call that chat line.
Come on.
Is there any way we could go to a hotel?
No.
I don't believe we're actually going to sleep in this.
Get in the back of the van! Get in the back of the van!
Now we're going to start wanking each other off.
Dermot, your sporting buddy...
Don't turn the light off!
Keep your sporting buddy away from me.
Ow!
I'm not sleeping here.
Oh, this is stupid. Please, can we not sleep here?
I've never been in a camper van.
Listen, we've got everything you need. The joke's over. Please, can we go and sleep somewhere normal?
Okay, so after a couple of hours watching grown men on their knees, I finally gave in and let the boys have a night in a hotel. I joined them, of course. But you're proud of yourselves.
We forced you to get us a hotel, so I think that's something to be proud of.
Today is the day, however, where you make it up to me and you learn to love sport. Are we ready?
Okay, yeah,
stop car racing.
Okay.
We high-fiving? Yeah, it's like being out with Americans. Let's go. Adam?
Yes, Dermot?
Your challenge is to come up with a song all about stock car racing.
Stick it up your ass.
Good. I don't think it should be called that.
Okay, a song about stock car racing.
We're all going to a place. It's a very, very happy place.
Can you imagine what I'm going to rhyme this with?
Sorry, I'm reading Depravicus. I'm not concentrating.
It's a stock car race?
Yeah.
In this very happy place are some people who like stock car racing.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Fucking hell, this really is like Mad Max. Look at this guy, he's from The Hills Have Eyes.
Wow.
Do not hurt us. We come in peace.
I didn't expect anything like this.
Look at him.
Holy shit. People from the outside. They bring with them coke. You, my friend, come here. You want to trade? We give you wheels. You have Coca-Cola. Come here.
There's a TV man. Rip him apart. Pull his legs off.
Hey, TV man, do a report on this. So, what are we thinking?
I'm thinking stay here, maybe go home.
I'm ready. I like it.
Really?
Come on.
We've got three names today. Yours is...
I'm Joe Corners.
I'm Naughty Scrapes. And I'm Dusty Lanes.
That's these right. Are our Days of Thunder names.
Adam and Joe. Hi, Adam.
Hey, well.
Hello, Adam. Nice
to meet
you.
Hi, Adam. Hi.
Okay, it's our first time today.
Right.
So tell us a little bit what we're
going to
expect here.
Well, we've got lots of stock car racing going on out there, coming out on track now, with some Dutch Formula One stock cars. The big event today is the UK final for the big Formula Ones. And also racing for the mini stocks, 10 to 15 year olds, and the V8s as well. So a big day for stock car racing.
Well, we haven't looked around yet, so what should we be seeing before?
Well, if you go down the pitch, you'll see all the guys working, everybody getting ready in the cars, the track shot, the spectators, everybody. Lots and lots to look around in. Pitch probably the most interesting place, I would have thought.
Paul, thank you very much.
All the best. Love all seeing you out there.
Thanks, Paul.
Okay.
Cheers, Paul.
All the best. Cheers.
Okay, so guys, what are you thinking so far?
I wonder whether it's possible just to race them on foot.
There is that.
Or wrestle them. How worrying is that? Sorry. Just three paramedics running past me. It's going really fast, with a sense of urgency and an enormous big first aid kit. And the race hasn't even started yet. What's happened?
Can't tell.
Can you not? Well, you can't tell us, or you can't tell yet? You can't?
Well, we had one chap got injured in the paddock box in six areas.
Yeah? What's the worst thing you've ever seen?
His head came off.
No!
What's the worst thing you've ever seen that since you've been down here?
A couple of cars tipped up.
What happens then? I mean...
They're in the track, though.
Are they all right?
Yeah.
Decapitated.
No!
Can you give us any, like, pre-race advice for how to stay safe?
Yeah, just don't get involved.
Don't race. So we're going out in the mini stocks at the end of the day, racing against the 10 to 15 year olds. Personally, I'm quite frightened. I'm more frightened of kids than I am of adults. And frankly, I'm quite worried about my little mini being flipped. Is that possible?
Yeah.
How often do they flip? Like, are a few guaranteed to flip every race? To be straight with me, please.
That's how inexperienced you are, mate.
Very inexperienced.
Fairly guaranteed,
yeah.
Then, isn't it?
Yeah.
Guaranteed. Yeah. This is Dax. Dax, say what you just said to me about the race.
He better wear some extra shorts, because he'll probably bab himself.
I'll bab myself?
Yeah.
That means shit myself?
Yeah.
Hello, buddies. How are you doing?
It's not a good start, Diamond.
No, it's not. We're kissing it. Good news and bad news. What do you want?
I want the bad news first.
The good news is we're going to go to the track shop, have a little look around, and then have something to eat.
Great.
Yeah.
And the bad news?
The minis that can accommodate adults are kind of bust. I think there's maybe about one.
So we're not racing?
There. We're taking a minute step up a level.
F2?
V8.
V8? Those are aeroplanes, aren't they?
No, it's like a sort of tomato juice.
It's a mixture of both.
A tomato juice-powered aeroplane?
Yeah.
Wicked.
That's amazing.
You'll love it.
What do you actually mean, Dermot?
I mean, we're racing in big cars.
What do they look like? Are they the ones with the...
But does
with
that
the big
still mean...
on the top?
We're not... But
we're racing against little cars.
No.
We're racing against kids, though, right?
No.
Oh, fuck that. I saw those bastards race. They're vicious.
Guys, we're almost there. We've got our four drivers behind us, looking very mean, it has to be said.
They're not aged 10 to 16, Dermot.
I know, I was lying. As in every Sporting Bunny show, we have a montage. You just have to pick the music it goes to. What do you fancy? We've got Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, Dukes of Hazzard.
Well, personally, I'd go for the Dukes.
I'd say the Dukes as well.
Any specific track?
Just a good old boy.
There you go. Gentlemen. To your cars.
Okay.
Good old boy. Never meaning no harm.
Okay. Everything's fine. You'll be fine. It's only a show for television. It's only Dermot O'Leary.
Take it slow. The man said take it slow.
So then, the celebrity drivers line up at the front of the grid. Remembering car number 44 is Dermot O'Leary. And alongside him are his sporting buddies in the shape of car number 259, Joe Cornish.
Let's party!
And a treble two, Adam Buxton. The leader of the way is Dermot O'Leary, car number 44. He leaves the treble two car, Adam Buxton, for dead.
Get third, you idiot. There we go.
Dermot O'Leary, who leads the way in car number 44, in second place is John Smith in car number 1. No! Dearie me! Dermot O'Leary, put the old power down, goes spinning out into the tyre.
Dermot's out! He's out! Yes! Come on now.
So then Dermot O'Leary gets going again. Leading the way is car number 1 and 93, John Smith, 244 is second, 159 is third. In fourth place is the first of our guest drivers, that's Joe Cornish.
Well, it looks like I'm going to live, so maybe I should drive a little more dangerous.
Oh, man, this guy's going to overtake me, and I'm going to get really freaked out!
Dermot O'Leary certainly getting a little bit heavy there in the 44 car. Oh, there it is, Dermot O'Leary, they're all over the place in the 44 car. And, oh, that's the old tyre. Manages. Just to get going, and now he's in the fence over there, in the 44 car.
This is not going well.
Who's that out of the race? Two drivers out of the race. There's been a spin out.
Celebrity cars left running at Travel 2.
Just the embarrassment. The utter embarrassment of it. I can believe it.
Is that O'Leary being dragged off? What a nonce.
Green flag goes now. We're back racing.
Taking it too slow. Is there anyone behind me? No.
That's what I'm talking about. You know.
And it's kind of a 1.93. John Smith and Lees has got out of action. 1.592. Travel 2 is third with Cottrell. Right behind him in 5.75. Will Cottrell try and use
one of the next?
Travel 2! And it loses them. And he comes up in second place. And the rest of them come across as well.
Is that it then? Is that over? I want more! He goes that way up, I believe.
Thank you.
Come on, matey.
Well, firstly, apologies for like stacking.
What happened to you, Dusty Skids?
I don't know. It was going really well, and then I just thought, well, this is good. I'll just see if I can go faster, and I genuinely couldn't go faster because I just started hitting stuff. Did you witness my spectacular
crash? I didn't.
Crash?
I wish I had.
What about you, Joe Corners?
I loved it. I felt I was only just starting when it all finished.
Yeah, yeah.
That was such good fun.
It was brilliant, wasn't it?
What about you? You did really well. You're right. You came third.
I thought I came first, didn't I?
Did you? Did you?
I felt like I came first.
I believe. Maybe.
That was a rush.
It really was.
It was. Hey, it was better than sex.
Oh, come on.
Your favourite part of the day?
I've met your wife, and I agree it probably is. But you really damaged the car, didn't you?
Yes, I know. I feel really bad
so
about it.
So licence fee is going to go up a little bit next year, just by a penny.
Your favourite part of the day?
Just that.
Without doubt. Well, we want to go back out again. I want to drive properly. That felt like Fisher Price.
Okay.
I want to do some proper driving.
And lads, would you say now at least, you know, we've become sporting buddies?
I'd prefer to use the phrase, how good are buddies are we?
And we are.
And your answer
we
would
are
be?
A very big sporting buddies.
Yeah.
Group hug.
Come on.
Carry me home.
Now let's go and have sex.
Carry me home.
Okay.
Next on BBC Choice, I'm Alan Partridge, right after 60 seconds.